Today we are bringing France to our kitchen by making an Instant Pot dish inspired by French onion soup. This is a French onion chicken bake and it's super easy to make, so keep on watching the video and we're gonna go through the steps together. What's up, everybody? Welcome to The Four and Fork. My name's Alexandria, and this is The Four and Fork Kitchen, where we are cooking one meal from every country in the world. And if you head on over to my blog website, this week is France week. So we are gonna be making a French-inspired dish, French onion chicken. So they may not eat this dish in France, but it's inspired by the magnificent French onion soup. We're turning it into a chicken bake made in the Instant Pot, and it is delicious. So we're gonna get started right now. First thing you're gonna need is six boneless, skinless chicken thighs. What we're gonna need to do is pound these so that they're a little bit thinner. So I'm gonna take a gallon-sized Ziploc bag and put the chicken thighs in the bag. I'm gonna kinda like open them up so that they lay flat, like this. And then I'm gonna put the thighs in the bag. I have a meat cleaver, so I'm gonna use this to pound on the bag. Make sure that the Ziploc bag is zipped all the way shut so that you don't get chicken, raw chicken everywhere. So you can see our chicken has flattened a little bit. That's a lot better. It'll be easier for us to cook with that in the Instant Pot. The next thing we're gonna do is flour the chicken. I have a half cup of flour. I'm gonna put it in a shallow bowl. I use a pie pan, but you can use anything where you can fit the whole chicken piece in there. I'm just gonna kinda move this around. So I got a nice layer of flour. And then each chicken thigh, I'm gonna dip each side in the flour and bring it out so it has flour coating on it. You can also trim the fat off of the chicken thighs if you prefer to do that too. The next thing we're gonna do is brown the chicken in the Instant Pot on the saute setting. So I've set my Instant Pot to the saute function and I'm gonna add 1 tablespoon of butter in here. Once the butter has melted completely, it's time to brown the chicken thighs. In a single layer, I'm gonna add the chicken thighs into the pot. I mean, the chicken is not gonna be cooked all the way through by the time we're done with this step. We're just gonna brown the outsides of it. So I do about 3 at a time, allow it to brown on the outside, and then I'll flip it over. Once your chicken is brown on both sides, you can remove it to a plate and keep the saute function on, because the next thing that we're gonna do is saute the onions for the French onion. So I have another 2 tablespoons of butter that I'm gonna put in here and allow it to melt again. And then I took 2 onions and I sliced them up pretty finely. So I cut each of the onions in half and then cut each of those halves into slices. And I'm gonna brown those in the Instant Pot. I've turned the temperature down a little bit because I don't wanna crisp them up, I just want them to soften. So on the batch of chicken, I had the temperature a little bit higher to brown the skins, and then I reduced that temperature to cook the onions. Once your onions have softened, then it's time to fill the pot and actually cook everything together. So I'm gonna turn my pot off of the saute function, and then I'm gonna add 1 cup of beef broth into the pot. And I'm gonna use either like a wooden spoon or my tongs and just kind of scrape the bottom of the pot, make sure that there's no browned bits that are still stuck to the bottom. I've been kind of doing that the whole time that I've been cooking the onions, but I'm just gonna give it one good scrape just to make sure. In here, I'm also gonna add all of the chicken pieces, so all 6 chicken thighs. They don't have to be covered in the beef broth or anything, you can just put them in there. To this, I'm also gonna add about a half teaspoon of salt, a half teaspoon of ground thyme, 1 teaspoon of oregano, some black pepper to taste, probably about 1/4 teaspoon to a half teaspoon, and 2 tablespoons of balsamic vinegar. I'm gonna kinda like just make sure that the seasonings get mixed in there with the liquid. We're gonna put the lid on the pot and turn it to high pressure. It's gonna cook on high pressure for 9 minutes. And then when the 9 minutes is done, we're gonna let it do a natural pressure release for 10 minutes and then release the pressure immediately after the 10 minutes is done. After we release the pressure from the pot, it's time to thicken the sauce. So the first thing that we're gonna do is remove the chicken thighs to a clean plate. We're gonna turn the pot back to the saute function and bring it to a boil. As it's heating up, I have 5 tablespoons of water here and 1.5 tablespoons of cornstarch. So I'm gonna dump the cornstarch into the water and mix it up to form a slurry. And then we're gonna add that into the boiling broth. And as it boils, the cornstarch is gonna start thickening that sauce. I recently made a recipe for French onion soup on my blog, and you can find that recipe at the link in the description of this video. And it was so delicious that I thought it would be really good as a chicken recipe, and so that is how this recipe was born. If your sauce isn't thickening up, you can also add another 1/2 tablespoon of cornstarch to another 1 tablespoon of water. Mix it together to form a slurry, and you can add it into the sauce again. If you're cooking it for, I don't know, over 5 minutes and it's still not thickening, you can do that too. As I stir now, I can tell that the sauce is starting to thicken. So once it's the consistency that I want, I'm gonna turn the saute function off And we have one more step before we're finally done with this recipe. You can add the chicken thighs back into the pot, and I'm gonna sprinkle 1/2 cup of shredded mozzarella cheese on top so that when I pull the chicken out, there's some nice cheesy goodness on top of it. The Instant Pot isn't on, or there's no pressure settings on or anything like that, but I just put the lid on top of the pot to hold some of the heat in, and I'm gonna leave it there for about a minute or so until the cheese fully melts, and then it's time to serve. And that is how you make French onion chicken in your Instant Pot. It may not look like the most beautiful dish, but I promise you it is so tasty. It's full of flavor and the chicken is so tender and delicious, and I know you're gonna love it. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thanks for hanging out with me. If you want the written instructions to this recipe, you can find them in the description below. And make sure that you check out all of the other recipes that I have on this channel. I have delicious Instant Pot recipes and recipes from all around the world, so I know that you're gonna love what you find. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to put some culture in your kitchen next week, and I will see you next week.